did you guys, is this like trivia? Do you know that 8 teams are opening their camps today? Rookie report date is
Thank
here.
You.
Yeah. Oh, I hear you, Hammy. Bears, Saints, Niners, Bills, Chiefs, Dolphins, Chargers, and the Hamilton-loved Giants. Okay, so between that and what's been coming out of Hard Knocks, it did get us thinking, and we would argue that outside of quarterbacks, Giants receiver Malik Nabers is the single most important rookie to his team this season. Hear me out. If the Giants are going to have any shot at getting back to the playoffs, and if Daniel Jones is going to turn these workout videos into results on the field and can prove that he is the team's starting quarterback going forward, it's going to be because Malik Nabers is that man. I do believe part of the reason the Giants have struggled to find consistency is because of what's gone on here at receiver. They're the only team in the entire NFL that hasn't had a receiver put up 800-plus yards in any of the last 5 seasons. And I know you're saying, well, the quarterback's throwing to him. No. To put that into perspective, 28 teams had a player that hit 800-yard mark last year, okay, alone. 20 last year alone. 11 of those that had multiple guys do it. Multiple guys do it, okay? That's a lot of hitting 800. Isn't that crazy? Multiple guys, 20, like it's crazy. They haven't had a dude do it in 5 years. Does that change with Nabers? I think it does. He brings everything you want to the table. Physical skills, the speed. We got hands, we got route running, everything you want. All-time leading receiving leader at LSU, of all places. That means he did better, we've talked about this on the show before, Jamar, better than Justin, better than OBJ, those LSU dudes. So I'm also loving what we're seeing and hearing on Hard Knocks. I'm not all caught up, but check this out, as I haven't seen it either.
How do you handle losing? Be straight.
Not at all. I really hate it. Okay. I hate losing more than I love winning.
Okay, and then how do you handle not being involved early in the game?
How do I handle it?
Yeah.
I handle it pretty tough, especially, you know, during the week.
That's what I'm looking for.
Been in the offense, you know, in the week, you know, putting in the work with the one offense, getting a lot of plays, you know, known to be called for me. So if I'm not in those plays and not getting the ball, you know, I'm pretty hard on it.
I love the honesty. And if you're knocking what he had to say, I think you're missing the point. It's not selfish that he wants the ball. He wants the ball because he knows the impact he can have for his team when he gets involved in the game. I challenge you to find me one star receiver, one bona fide star receiver who doesn't feel that way. Not even a star. Any receiver who doesn't feel this way. He's the difference maker, isn't he? With Saquon gone, with all of that, Hamilton. And let's not forget that I saw Malik Nabers, who wanted nothing to do with me. We were in Frisco, and we saw Malik Nabers, and he was working out. He was, like, getting it in. Like, he was really focused. And I just mosey on out there like an idiot, and I sit next to him, and I'm just like, hey. And we start talking. He was very focused, it was so hot out there. I feel bad. I was trying to make him talk to me. But that's what kind of got us thinking about this and the impact he can make, especially sans Saquon.
Yeah, and it was cool. He was super locked in. Still had those chains, the chains on, which was working out in those must not be easy. But no, I'm with you. I think the talent level with him is next level. It's something the Giants haven't had since Odell left, and they've struggled. They've tried a lot of different things to replace that production, and they haven't been able to. So it's going to be huge to see what Malik can do for them this year.
You want him to want the ball. Let's just put you want him to say, Daniel, hit me.